press the bell icon on the YouTube app to never miss a video from News Laundry.
Hello and welcome to News Laundry Interviews. Today I have with me two very special people who have co-authored a book. We'll just plug your book first. Black Warrant, Confessions of a Tihar Jailor. I'm not exaggerating when I say this is one of the most compelling and disturbing books I have read in a while. This book, Black Warrant, is the warrant that is issued after a death penalty is announced. And Sunil Gupta has worked in Tihar Jail for 35 years.
Yeah.
And you have just retired.
Yeah.
And you have overseen 11 hangings, is that
Eight.
Right? Eight hangings. And we will talk about those in some detail. But and Sunetra Choudhury, as many of you know, is a very well-known, prominent journalist. She was an anchor, now she's with Hindustan Times. Although, Sunilji, you have given the jailer's perspective, but I will talk about this in some detail about, you have a very humane gene, I guess, to you, where you can empathize with even the most horrible people. And I guess that's part of your job. I'm not sure how many people do it, but welcome to News Laundry.
Thank you.
And I can't wait to start talking to you. Just letting you know, right at the top, I may offend you with some of my questions, so please.
Sure, you are welcome.
Don't mind.
You are welcome. You are welcome.
Now, Sunetra, you know, no offense to Mr. Gupta, lekin sir, kal yug hai, saggon ka confirm karna padta hai, baat sachi hai ki nahi. You're a journalist and you're a very accomplished journalist. For a book like this, you only have his word, right? There is no triangulation of sources. How do you decide to co-author a book where there is no way that you can check that while Mr. Gupta says that, you know, there's so much ugliness there, that he was not one of those?
So this was a huge issue because you hear of so many custodial deaths, especially of the fact that, you know, we've heard in the, you know, when I did my interviews for the first one, it became very, very apparent that the kind of brutalities that go on in jails, that to be seen as giving a platform to someone who was an enforcer of jail rules was a little tricky. But I think I wrote this in the introduction as well, that what we did was, first of all, establish his credentials. So not just, first of all, Sunil Gupta is known to every journalist for the last four decades.
Okay.
So it was a thing of speaking to people and just saying that, okay, I know he's fine, but what's your thing? Then what we did was also that we had to ensure, we also spoke to Delhi government, because as he said, that they report to Delhi government. So we had to check that, is there anything, because, you know, there are, in fact, he got into a bit of a fight with Alok Verma, right? That's there in the
book last chapter.
Would I be embarrassed later? Is his credibility a little bit of a problem?
So, they said, which Delhi government did you
right
check?
Right now.
The Kejriwal.
Yeah, the Kejriwal
and
government.
And he didn't say, sab mile hue hain ji. Acha. Bach gaye sir aap, nahi to sabko ek. Like, you know, most people would think that when you go to a place like a Tihar jail, your inhumanity will rise in the sense that you get desensitized. You are confronted with the worst of the worst, so it's very easy to demonize. Whereas through your book, you have that unique ability of looking at everybody as a human with frailties, no matter how horrific the deed they've done. Just take me through that.
So we used to consider Tihar as a family. Aapko hairani hogi, jab aap jail mein jayenge, to aap kisi se baat kar rahe hain.
आपको इतना कॉन्फिडेंस है कि जब मैं जेल में जाऊंगा खैर
नहीं आप
अगर मैं जेल
एज ए जर्नलिस्ट एज ए जर्नलिस्ट मैं कह रहा हूं फॉर अस द जेल इज लाइक ए फैमिली हूएवर इज कमिंग टू द जेल हाउ इनह्यूमन ही मे बी आउटसाइड बट व्हेन ही इज कमिंग टू द प्रिजन ही इज आवर फैमिली किसी का बर्थडे होता है हम बर्थडे मनाते हैं किसी का अब चार्ल्स सोबराज का मैसेज बता रहा था वो इसमें नहीं लिखा हुआ चार्ल्स सोबराज वाज ए फैमिली फॉर अस जब उसने कहा कि मेरा बर्थडे है तो मैं मिठाई खिलाना चाहता हूँ लोगों को वी वर नेवर सस्पिशियस दैट ही मे मिक्स्ड दीज सीडेटिव इन दी दैट स्वीट्स तो उसने वो ट्रस्ट तोड़ा
सुनेत्रा यू नो इन दिस दैट एपिसोड विद राम सिंह द ज्योति सिंह रेपिस्ट एंड मर्डरर यू नो द काइंड ऑफ ह्यूमन फेस दैट सुनील गिव्स टू हिम इन दैट इंटरेक्शन यू नो एज अ वुमन स्पेशली डिड यू फाइंड इट हार्ड टू काइंड ऑफ articulate that or can you see that human side of Ram Singh as well?
Right from the word go, it was very obvious that he and I, Sunil Ji and I, are coming from very different worlds at this. So you have to, I cannot do a book like this and bring my sensibilities in. What I can do, of course, is to make people aware that, you know, I knew that I was looking at it in a very stark manner. I think more than Ram Singh, because his interaction with Ram Singh was a bit limited. I think I could see what was perhaps a little problematic for me was how much Sunil Gupta was fond of Manu Sharma.
Yeah.
You know, I think that I found, because I think Manu Sharma has been the defining case of my career. I'll say why, because I was an intern when the murder happened. So I've seen this various state, and the story continues.
Let me give context. Sunil has at, you know, one point spoken on Manu Sharma having been key to develop Tihar Jail's product line and grown from, I think, what, 6 crores to 16 crores or whatever. He was very good at helping other prisoners out. Because padha likha tha, wo bade baap ka aulad tha. His father bought a 5-star hotel close to Tihar Jail.
So, you know, that I found problematic. Because this person who, you know, we see the influence that and the kind of privilege that money brings as an outsider and as an observer very, very clearly, right? I mean, how, you know, your father's such a big politician that first you try and subvert the law. Once that doesn't work and you get sentenced to life, you buy a hotel. Everybody goes over there. They get privileges. They're treated well.
Maqbool Butt was a Kashmiri terrorist. आप कह सकते हैं एंड अफजल गुरु तो आप लोग जानते होंगे रिसेंटली अफजल के नाम पर चाहे जेएनयू का बथेरे झगड़े हुए हैं आपने उनका 8 यू नो सबका आपने लास्ट डेज का पूरा दिया है अकाउंट इनका लास्ट डेज का अकाउंट दिया है इन वन केस इंदिरा गांधी वाज द प्राइम मिनिस्टर एंड इन द अदर केस मनमोहन सिंह वाज द प्राइम मिनिस्टर इन बोथ केसेस इट वाज डन इन एन इलीगल वे द स्टेट took the life of a man illegally, which is normally we would call murder. Aisi sthiti mein, how can you still believe in justice when you see this up close? Ki bhai, that's one part of the question. Aur dusra part hai ki main thoda anecdote bata dun. Jab Afzal Guru ko jab bataya gaya that next morning he's going to die, sabko last ichha di jati hai. Lekin usne ek cup chai mangi, dusri cup ke liye banda chala gaya tha. He couldn't even get the second cup of tea. And then you sat with him and sang, Apne liye jiye to kya jiye. And both these men embraced death gracefully. Why was their last message, at least Maqbool Butt's last message, not relayed and you have relayed it through your book? A, are you afraid that will lead to repercussions? Because the last message he wanted put out there was, ki Maqbool Butt mare na bare, Kashmir ka andolan zinda rehna chahiye. And would that make you reconsider your position on reform? Can people like this be reformed?
तो मकबूल भट्ट ने जो लिख के दिया था बेसिकली यू नो द मैजिस्ट्रेट इज प्रेजेंट एट द टाइम ऑफ एग्जीक्यूशन जस्ट इफ ही वांट टू डिवॉल्व एनी दिस वर्ल्डली थिंग टू हिज सन और टू हिज फैमिली
ही कैन डिवॉल्व
विल वगैरह अपने इसलिए होता है उसका और कोई काम नहीं होता तो जब मुझे याद है उस टाइम पे एक सरदार जी एक मैजिस्ट्रेट थे नाम मुझे ध्यान आ जाएगा तो जब वो उसके पास गए तो उन्होंने जो लिखा तो सरदार जी यूँ उसको लिखते गए जो बोला तो उन्होंने जब बात की उन्होंने लिखना शुरू कर दिया तो मैं साथ मैंने कहा यार लिख क्या रहे वो तो कुछ बोली मतलब वो जो वो बोल रहा था वो ये कह रहा था कि जो स्ट्रगल है मेरा ये कंटिन्यू रहना चाहिए उसने इस टाइप का उसमें जो है लिखा था उन दिनों में शायद किसी अखबार में भी ये वाली बात आई थी तो मैं अगर कंपैरिजन करता हूँ इसका और अफजल के साथ मकबूल भट्ट जो है ही वाज लिटिल बिट जब उनको फांसी दी लिटिल बिट आप कह सकते हैं मैं मतलब वैसे ही वाज वेरी कॉन्फिडेंट अब आराम से गए ही वाज लिटिल बिट उनका चेहरा जो है ना काला सा हो गया था पर व्हेन आई कंपेयर दैट विद अफजल तो अफजल के उसमें कोई जब मैंने उसको कहा कि तुम्हें फांसी दी जानी है क्यों बेसिकली दिस इज द वर्क ऑफ सुपरिटेंडेंट जेल मैं और सुपरिटेंडेंट जेल दोनों हम साथ थे और जेल का और स्टाफ भी वहाँ पे था तो जब उसको कहा कि फांसी दी जानी है तो वो कहता हाँ मुझे मालूम है तो मैं कहा ये तो बहुत ही मैच्योर वो है फिर उसने हमारे साथ बैठ के आराम से चाय पी और बड़ी खुल के बात की उसने और मैं तो हैरान हुआ कि जिसको मैं इतना बड़ा टेररिस्ट समझता था वो इस तरीके से बात कर और प्लस जो उसने रिवीलिंग बात कही मेरे को उसने कहा कि मैं कोई वो टेररिस्ट नहीं हूँ, मैं कोई ये नहीं कि मैं इसको इंडिया से अलग करना चाहता था, मैं तो खाली एक जो एक है मैं करप्शन से लड़ रहा था। कहते करप्ट लोगों ने मुझे टेररिस्ट बना दिया। मुझे ये बात उसकी बहुत ही अच्छी लगी।
और जब वो एक्चुअली गैलोस पे गया, बोल रहे हैं कि अब हैंगमैन नहीं है, वन अदर थिंग दैट वन रियलाइजेस कि देयर वेरी फ्यू हैंगमैन इन द कंट्री, तो यू आर क्लियरली ओवरकम बाय व्हाट हैपेंड विद अफजल। सॉरी, वुड लाइक अस टू stop. Would you like to stop? Okay, just cut, guys. One second.
Okay, starting again.
तो उसने कहा कि मैं तो सिस्टम के खिलाफ लड़ रहा था, मुझे इन्होंने टेररिस्ट बना दिया, तो मुझे भी लगा कि मैं भी जैसे सिस्टम के खिलाफ लड़ रहा हूँ। मैंने बहुत सारी चीज़ें की हैं जिसमें कि करप्शन को मैं अब सिंगल लेवल बहुत छोटा सा मैं आदमी हूँ कुछ कर सकूँ, तो मुझे अपने में वो नजर आया।
When procedures are breached, rules are broken.
Yeah.
That I'm not talking about. It could be Afzal, it could be somebody else. It could be Satwant Singh.
Yeah.
The Indian state says you cannot hang a man who's not of sound mind.
Yeah.
Satwant Singh was clearly insane by the time he was hanged.
Yeah.
So I'm not talking about whether it's Afzal or whether it's Satwant.
For sure.
The highest law of the land, while murdering, taking the life of a man,
in, for sure,
legally,
yeah,
has broken rules.
Yeah.
That's a big deal. Satwant Singh was the year, he was 22 when he emptied out his magazine on Indira Gandhi. And Keher Singh was much older, who was seen as the ideologue. Now, if I remember, the account that had come out in the paper at that time said that Satwant Singh, his legs buckled and he had to actually be dragged because his legs gave way. Whereas Keher Singh walked right there and Keher Singh was unafraid. Your account indicates that both men were very scared by the time they were being hanged. But yet, in the last line, you say they will be known as the men who, while being hanged, said, Jo bole so nihal. A, did they say that when they were being hanged?
Yeah, yeah.
And B, were both equally scared, although Satwant Singh was by that time not mentally sound?
Yeah, Satwant Singh was more scared, but this Keher Singh. Basically, you know, Keher Singh used to read a lot of religious scriptures. Lot of religious scriptures. But Satwant was not like that. Basically, you know, our legal system is, I am just expanding what Sunetra has stated. Basically, you know, in our legal system, the poor is always on the receiving end. Always on the receiving end. Had there been some rich person in place of Ram Singh, so nobody has spoken so much about him, had he been of paisa wala or
he may not have been hanged. Aapko kabhi lagta hai aapke intellectual capability aur emotional aapki jo maturity hai uske hisab se aap ye 35 saal kahin aur dete to kuch zyada behtar hota? I mean, sorry to sound a little cruel, do you feel you wasted 35 years of your life?
Nahi, basically kya hai ki इसमें हमने लिखा भी है, देर इज़ अ लॉट ऑफ डिफरेंस दी व्हेन आई ज्वाइंड देयर इन 1981 एंड टिल डेट देर हैव बीन लॉट ऑफ रिफॉर्म्स, बट द थिंग विच इज सेम इज दैट दीज इन्फ्लुएंशियल पीपल दे आर गेटिंग फेवरेबल।
सुब्रत रॉय आप बता रहे थे उसके पैर छूते हैं,
दिस इज द सेम। आई हैव सीन दैट व्हेन एवर सम इन्फ्लुएंशियल पीपल, व्हेन एवर सम इन्फ्लुएंशियल पीपल और some big badmash, they have come, they are enjoying every facility.
In fact, in one of the cases, jab aapko jail shift karna tha, aap uske usne talwar nikal di thi. Kya naam tha uska?
Jassa.
Jassa, matlab, you have to read that episode, I won't give it away, but kalia ka jo wo scene hai ki line wahi se shuru hoti hai jahan kalia khada tha, us type ke bande actually hote hain jail mein.
Ha, us type ke hote hain.
You know, Alok Verma, the former CBI chief, aapne kafi logon ko kafi serious allegations lagaye. Are you afraid of any legal repercussion? You have said stuff that, you know, how people who should enforce the law bypass the law, and now you are not in uniform anymore, you are a civilian. Are you not afraid?
Nahi, basically, you know, we have written this book. I have spoken from my heart. Jo bhi mujhe laga tha, theek ko maine likha. Then it is for others also to see ki what they have to write, what they have not to write.
So, Sunetra, this is 178 pages, and in the forward you've said that after your last book you were not supposed to write one. But this is this is not a 176-page book. This is a 500-page book, which is yet to be written. Will you be doing that?
I don't know. I don't know. I always think no. If you ask me right now, I don't think that. I think maybe a fresh set of eyes, perhaps. But then I think, you know, I'm hearing this Leo story and I'm wondering, why didn't he tell me this?
The book is called Black Warrant, Confession of Tihar Jailor, which is, I'm dissatisfied with, because it should have been a 500-page book. It has some of the most gripping and interesting conundrums. I mean, I think it's a must read for people who want to understand justice, you know, the judiciary, the police force, and also just at a philosophical level, it's an important book. So I think it's very brave of you to have written it. Thank you so much. To watch the full interview, you have to be a subscriber. So pay to keep news free and get the full unedited interview on newslaundry.com.